Okay, let's get down to business. The way I see it, someone's out to make a sequel to a late-stage franchise revival. Cash in on all the movie murder long-delayed sequel hoopla. So it's our job to observe the rules of a sequel to a late-stage franchise revival. Number one, you gotta have a new location. Woodsboro, it's kinda played out. They did it in Scream, they did it in Scream 4, they did it in Scream 5, and you can use that sweet, sweet sequel money to do some location shooting. So you take the surviving cast from the previous movie, and you drop them all in the Big Apple. It worked for Jason.
Huh? What?
So you have Melissa Barrera returning as Sam Carpenter, and you also bring back Jenna Ortega in an expanded role as her sister Tara. You don't have to worry about opening weekend when you start with Wednesday, am I right? Anyway, you move the four core survivors from the original film to New York, and you make the film about trauma. Get some of that Jamie Lee Curtis goodness going on in there. Kind of make it a sequel about being a sequel, about how making a sequel re-traumatizes all your characters and all that. Give our killer, or killers, some motive that ties back to the previous film, specifically targeting Sam and her friends. But don't lean too heavy on it, we're mainly here for the stabbing. Which brings me to rule number two. You bring back the guys who did a good job last time. That means directors Matt Bettinelli-Oplin and Tyler Gillette. You know, the dudes who did Ready or Not. Two directors who know their way around a slasher movie. In fact, get them to bring a couple of friends along for the ride this time. Round out the cast a bit with new arrivals like Samara Weaving or Henry Cherney. You're six movies in at this point. You don't want to upset the apple cart. You just want a number of very effective individual sequences that are nasty enough and inventive enough to keep the movie chugging along. Carnage candy. You get some good tense moments, some playful set pieces. These guys are good at suspense. You're gonna get a movie that works reasonably well as a slasher movie on a scene-to-scene basis. And that's when we hit rule number three. Ditch the meta aspect. It's not 1996 anymore. Irony may not be dead, but it's bleeding out from multiple stab wounds. America has voted with their wallets, and they want Tom Cruise riding a jet fighter and James Cameron's cool whale friends. Sure, you might tease a little bit here or there, drop in some franchise terminology, set up an introductory sequence that teases a much more interesting film than what you end up getting, but you mostly play it straight. These movies used to be deconstructions and interrogations of the horror genre, and the last film kinda made a point about fandom. But really what you're delivering is the kind of movie the original was reinventing, and audiences will buy it as long as you drop in some nostalgia nuggets, like say the character everybody thought was dead from the fourth film but whose appearance you seeded with an Easter egg in the fifth film, or the only remaining original cast member who's still in your budget range after location shooting. And now, rule number four, the big one. You can have all the gore you want, but this one's gonna be pretty bloodless. Your leads are too popular to kill, and your online fans are too angry to provoke. Woe betide you if you kill anyone's favorite character. You can stab them a bit, hell, you can stab them a lot, but you gotta remind the audience that there's even less sense of tension and peril this time than there was last time. The training wheels are still on, the buffer's still up. And if you follow all these rules, you end up with a basically competent but surprisingly bloodless late franchise installment that lacks both the killer instinct and the incisive wit that made the original films classics of the genre. It's a well-made late slasher sequel with some good kills, but one too beholden to modern franchise conventions to truly be a cut above. And you gotta release theatrically, in cinemas exclusively from March 10th. Sorry, I gotta get this.